Hi guys, and welcome to part 30 of Skyrim Mod Sanctuary. Now, in one of my recent Let's Play videos, I was having a little trouble with my horses, and I happened to say, wouldn't it be great if I could just summon several horses and have spectral horses appear, and me and my followers just could ride those instead. And someone sent me a link to a mod that in fact does allow you to summon a spectral horse. Now, unfortunately for me, it only summons a horse for me, and if you have another mod that lets you have your followers ride, one more horse for that one follower. But you do need that mod installed, and for example, if you're using the UFO mod and walking around with 10 followers, currently there's no way to get spectral horses for them. However, this mod is still brilliant. Now, the horse is fast, and I mean really fast. You go bombing along on this thing. And it also has unlimited stamina. As the mod author says, it doesn't breathe, so why would it run out of breath? So you can actually sprint everywhere. And as you can see, it leaves this very cool spectral trail behind it. So it's fast, it's useful, and it looks so impressive. I mean, you do look pretty scary riding through the land, especially at night time on this thing. And one of the other very useful things about this is when you finally get off the horse, it just disappears a few seconds later. So it's not going to attack with you, it's not going to run off. You just summon it again when you need it. And if for some reason blue is not your thing, you can get it in purple. Yes, that's right. You can actually get a custom paint job for your horse. And there are other versions. You can have the ice version, the version of the horse that looks like it's all icy. You can have a version of the horse that has electricity flying off it, the storm horse. There is even a flaming horse. Yes, a flaming horse. But my personal favourite, a horse made out of pure dark shadow. It's probably hard to see on the video, but you can actually just about see through this horse. And it has that very cool black smoke effect. Very evil looking. Now, you get this horse by buying it from a stone. You buy the spell from a stone that is very close to the Whiterun stables. And it will cost you 5,000 gold. So it's very expensive, but it is a very useful spell. And you can cast it as many times as you like, obviously. The same stone also allows you to customize the horse for speed, colour, etc. All round, this mod is really well done. I'm very impressed with it. It's very cool. A lot of nice little features. The only thing I want now is to be able to summon 15 of them for my horde of minions. Have you ever been annoyed by the fact that there is nothing for a mage character that can be made out of dragon materials? Your heavy warriors have their dragon armour, the light warriors have the dragon scale, and your robe wearers have nothing. Well, the next mod might well be for you. And the mod is called Dragonhide Robes. And essentially, it allows you to craft a set of robes for probably a mage character made out of dragon materials. The idea is it's made out of the dragon's skin and has some bones as ornamentation. The hood of the robe comes in two versions. There is a version that is just made out of the skin, and there is also a version that has bones for ornamentation, very similar to the jagged crown. Both are exactly the same stats as robes. There is no armour rating whatsoever. It's zero armor rating, and as such will not interfere with your mage perk in the alteration tree that gives you bonuses to your armor spells. Now, as I mentioned, the bone pieces are purely ornamental, obviously, because it's zero armor rating, but if you look at it and say to yourself, you know what, it does look like heavy armor, and I'll agree, it does look like heavy armor as well, you can actually craft a heavy armor version of it and a light armor version of it as well. However, for those, you're going to need the dragon smithing perk, just as you would with the armors, you need the perk. But for the robe, you don't need the perk. You craft that at at the tanning rack, and you can craft it immediately without any perks as long as you have enough dragon materials. Now, it's not at all overpowered because you can do this, because the robe is zero armor rating. So it's exactly the same as cloth armor. There is absolutely no difference between this and some cloth armor. You can enchant it. It has all the same statistics. It's purely how it looks. And, you know, if you want this look, it's brilliant. I mean, I think it's very appropriate for evil type characters, evil type mages. But even if you're playing good mages, it's got that dragon slayer look about it. You're walking around saying, "I kill dragons." Now, there are crowned versions for the beast races, but the author recommends that you use the normal cloth versions. So that's completely up to you, but you should be aware of that. Now, the next mod I'm going to cover is the Saber Gear Backpack. Now, this mod, quite obviously, adds a backpack. And this backpack looks good, it's lore-friendly, and it's also very useful. It adds 50 to your carrying capacity. It's actually based upon another mod called Fur Bag, but for some reason that mod, the backpack doesn't seem to appear on my back, so I haven't been able to show it. However, I will link it in the description below. Now, the Saber Gear Backpack actually has two versions. There is a survivalist version, and it has things like an axe, a torch, and potions added to the backpack, which give it a very rugged and cool look, so that's actually my personal favourite. If the colour isn't to your taste, there is also a black version and a white version. And all of these items are craftable, you don't need any perks for it, and they require pretty reasonable materials, the sort of stuff you will find fairly early on, so you can have these quite early in your gaming. Now, if that's still not enough carrying capacity for you, there is another mod called Bandolier Bags and Pouches, and it basically adds a lot of different items that will increase your carrying capacity. It adds a bandolier, which adds 50 to your carrying capacity, and it has a large bandolier, which adds 100 to your carrying capacity. It adds little pouches that go around your belt. You can have up to 6 of them, each of them with a capacity of 50. It adds a belt bag. It adds satchels, 2 satchels that hang off either shoulder. And you can even get a sort of an armoured version of the bandolier. It has a shoulder armour piece. Now, this clips if you're using armour that has shoulders already, but it's great for using with, say, robes or the iron armour, which doesn't have, you know, shoulder pieces, and looks really good. They also come in a couple of different colours. There is a grey version and a black version, so you can pick one that actually matches the look you're going for. And all of these items can be crafted at the tanning rack. They can be crafted pretty early on, and again, they require pretty reasonable materials. So there's no reason not to use these. You should take note of the fact that each item increases your carrying capacity by about 50, which is a little overpowered, actually, because you can become a veritable pack mule. I think there should be a more balanced version of this, where the pouches add maybe 15 to your carrying capacity, the satchels maybe 20, 25, bandolier a little more, etc. But to be honest, in this game, the carrying setup is a little unrealistic anyway, so why not? If you just want to carry tons and tons of treasure, this mod definitely is one that's going to allow you to hoard as much stuff as possible and sell it all for lots of gold. Okay, so installing the Conjure Rideable Ethereal Horse spell, which is one mouthful of a name, I must admit. I would rather it was called Summon Ghost Horse or something, but that's what it's called. Basically, click Download with Manager and install as normal. Very, very simple indeed. The Dragonhide robes, once again, single file, Download with Manager, hit Activate, you've got your mod. Saber Gear Backpack, same thing, Download with Manager. And the Bandolier Bags and Pouches, main files, download with manager. Now there is an optional file which will make them tight on the male bare body. So if you want to run around pretty much naked, or you have some type of armor on that has your upper body more or less naked, this optional file will make the bandolier a lot tighter. I will not be doing it, so I don't need it. So I just needed download with manager and activate. And that's it for all of those mods. Very, very simple indeed. Nothing really important. And that's it for this video. I hope it was helpful and I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, please click the like button. I always appreciate that. And keep sending in those screenshots. Absolutely loving them. Some of them are such good quality, it's amazing. If there are any major issues or unanswered questions that crop up, I will of course post an encore video for this one, and I will put a link for it right about here, and you can go visit that now. And if not, of course, I look forward to seeing you on the next video I make. And until then, as always, have fun.